I woke up this morning reflecting on how people are not listening to the message that my father is sending out. It has been amazing to witness how people are refuting that I am his prophet with in lieu of all of the proof that he has given to us in his scriptures. The question you might ask is, why is it important to know who his prophet is? The answer is because he is revealing to mankind the reason why he is going to destroy all that opposes his plan, and he is restoring many things to call a people to him. And he is doing this through his prophet. He's also calling us to help him build his family by helping him sound the alarms and to cry out for people to turn to the truth that would set them free. I would do a separate video called Proofs and Prophecies, so I will not go into them in this video. However, I have discussed some of them in other videos as well, such as the Signs from Heaven's Throne video. The fact is, if you are denying me, you are not really denying me, you are denying your Creator's word. And yes, this is a fact. It is not what I think that his word says that proves that I am his servant or not. It is what his word does say that proves that he has made me his servant. And the proof is irrefutable if you simply will believe him. You cannot get around this, no matter how you stack it up or slice it. Just as those who killed our Messiah could not get around the fact that it was his Father's word that testified to him as well. The proof was staring them in the face in the scriptures, yet they denied it anyway, and they killed him. Their rebellious hearts got in the way of them seeing the obvious truth. In the last few days, I witnessed a man that was coming to the truth be ambushed by the enemy, and it was all because he could not believe his Creator's word, even though it's staring him in the face. He kept getting caught up in arguments within his own reasoning, trying to prove that I was a real prophet or not, while rejecting the proof that was given to him in the scriptures. This video is not about this man, nor is it about me, but I'm going to use his example for his sake in hopes of him repenting from his errors, and for other people's sakes as well, who may get caught up in the same kind of reasoning that this man did. He says that he is all worried about drinking the Kool-Aid, so he is rightfully careful that we must not follow a man without proof, and I agree totally. However, we had sure better to be listening to our Creator's proof, because he gave it for a reason. He did all things for a reason. So we shouldn't listen to any proof that any man steps forward with their saying they, that's what Saul of Tarsus did, of course. And of course, the true word testifies that Saul was false. So, and the true word testifies that all who are false, just like it testifies that I'm speaking the truth. This man said that he is not challenging me, and I agree totally with him in this statement. He is not. He is challenging his Creator by challenging his Creator's word. He said in a post that he's just doing his job. This is a lie. He's doing Satan's job. He called me a self-proclaiming witness. This is a lie as well. My Father's word is my witness, and it testifies that I speak his truth. This man, however, has made himself a self-proclaiming witness. He has witnessed that I am false in his eyes, and he is bearing this witness to others. If I am the real deal, then he is a false witness. He is bearing his witness to others by doing a video to cast doubt against the truth. He says that he is not doing this, but he has and he is. He uses the same strategy that Saul of Tarsus used. This strategy is double talk. In one sentence, he says that he is not saying that I am not the witness, but in the next sentence, he says that he was stung by me and led astray, etc. He said that he might be facing off with Satan's followers, but in reality, he is facing off with his Creator. Satan's strategy is to put doubt to the truth. This is what he did with Eve. He twisted the truth to accomplish his deception. And this is what this man is doing as well. The way that Satan's servants work is not by saying outright that the truth is not the truth. They just cleverly try to discredit the parameters of it. And I really don't think that they do this intentionally. Their minds are just under Satan's programming and under his influence. This man said in his video that he went for a detour, implying that he was heading for the truth when he was led astray from it by me, is what he's alleging. But now he is doing his job and trying to expose that maybe I am false. This all started because I told him that he had to stop spreading his errors and doing his videos and such. Well, he is back to his teaching and his swill, and yes, anything that opposes my father's truth is swill. On whose authority is this man spewing his beliefs? It is on his own authority. I can guarantee you on whose authority that I am speaking, because my father testified to it ahead of time in his word. Sadly, you don't want to believe his word. Can this man or any of the rest of you putting forth your videos or your ministries about what you believe to be true make such a claim? You cannot. Maybe some of you claim to speak on the authority of a college education from a seminary or something like this. I make no such claim. My father's word testifies to me, but this is not good enough for most of you. I suppose if I had a bunch of degrees behind me, you would believe me then. This man said that many would come forward making huge announcements, etc. He is correct, but one would come forward in the name of the Most High and with his stamp of authenticity, and this has happened. This man has denied the stamp, and so many of you have. He heard the proof and he denied it, just as many of you listening to this have done as well. You have your preconceived ideas that the witnesses will be this or that, and the truth is just too far from what you believe to be true, what you've been taught by deceived men. Part of the witness against you is that you will not believe my father. By not believing my father's word, this man and some of you have called his word a lie, because it testifies to me just as it testified to his son. This man might think that he is just trying to warn others about me, but in actuality, he is putting forth discrediting information that is not true. And I'll explain some of them lies. I already explained one of them. He can do it in the name of being cautious, because there are many false prophets out there indeed, but this is not true, because he has not spoken the truth and he is discrediting my father's truth. So whatever he claims to be doing to warn people and what have you, he just lies to himself. This is how Satan works. This man is adding lie to lie. I said that he lied when he called me a self-proclaiming witness, when I brought forth the proof that my father has testified to me. Hiding behind denying his word is not going to be a good excuse for any of you who do the same. In his video, he said that I am misquoting the scriptures when I say over and over again in these videos that we were created to be made in the image of our Creator and in his likeness. He said this is a complete contradiction to what scripture says. Is this true, his statement? Or am I just telling you what 143,999 others have already gleaned from his word? Do you really think that any of you are already made in his image or in his character? Come on, people. You cannot believe such a foolish doctrine just because the translators translated it this way. Is a murderer or a rapist already made in his image? How about a child molester? Or how about all of you who are liars and adulterers? Are you already made to be in his image? If you can look the camera straight in the face and say that you are made in your Creator's image already, you are a liar, whether you are just lying to yourself or not. If you people want to believe the translations of pagan men instead of his prophet, that is your choice. This man seems to have made this choice, but I hope that he repents. Instead of posting a video implying that his Creator's prophet is false, maybe he should have invested in a concordance that shows the Hebrew grammatical notations. In Genesis 1:1, it says that Elohim created the heavens and the earth. It is the same Strong's word for created that is used in verse 27, where it says that he created man in his image, but it is used with completely different grammatical notations. In verse 1, it is used with a quality perfect notation, and in verse 27, it is used with two different grammatical notations, a quality imperfect notation and a wa consecutive notation. I have said in other videos that the Hebrew language is a reconstructed language, and it was. This cannot be denied if you study it. It is clear, no matter what you make of the different notations, that these two words used for the word created are totally different, because they have totally different notations associated with them in the Hebrew text. In verse 27, it is not past tense as it was after he had made the He had created the heavens and the earth in verse 1. If you think that you are already made in His image and call me false because I say differently, then go right ahead with your rebellious heart. That's all it is. I am just saying on the authority of Yahweh Elohim that you are a liar. I don't know. I'd like to know actually why any of you are here in the flesh. If you think this, then if in your self-righteous wisdom you already are created in His image, why are you even here? Oh, this man will be fueled by this statement. He'll say, see, where's the love? Where's the compassion? That's what he said in his video. He said in a letter to me as well. And I'm doing a video on this as well. It'll be doing shortly here. But anyway, what love is, where's the love will be the title of it. He'll say, I don't see Elohim in this, do you? And he actually said in a letter that he says, I know Yeshua, but I don't know you. Well, I can guarantee you, if he doesn't know who's living inside of me, he doesn't know the true Yeshua, because that's who's living inside of me. And it's all about the love. And this video is all about love, but he won't be able to see that, I'm sure. Just many of you won't. It just so happens that this man's video might lead one astray who my father and his saints want in his family. His lies might lead another to the lake of fire, and I'm not going to let his erroneous teachings go unchecked, because I do love others. I love people that are watching his channel and listening to his swill, and they might be led by his doubting evidences that he has put forth that aren't true. And I love this man, and I hope that he returns to the path that he embarked on before his detour. I can guarantee you coming to the Repairing the Breach website channel was not his detour, but he certainly did take a detour. And where is his love for blabbing his lies to others to possibly lead them to the lake of fire? I have said in other videos that we had better to fear leading another astray with all of our being. Obviously, this man does not have this fear, because he is quick to post his opinions. I have gone to him alone. I told him the truth and told him to stop with his teachings and to be a student, and he rejected this instruction. He actually said in his video that how I respond to him will prove further that I'm false if I respond in a way that condemns him, basically, I guess is what he's implying. It's because he doesn't understand love. He doesn't understand how he is the one that doesn't love. So now he is getting more reproof. But again, it is not about me or him. It is about the truth that will set us free. I'm just doing this video because, like I said, other people will possibly fall into the same trap, and it's a good time to use it for an example. It is not love to teach false doctrines or to blaspheme the truth to others. If anyone points another to a different path than the true path, Scripture says that they must be put to death for this reason, so that others will not be led astray by them and led from eternal life. It's not love to lead somebody from eternal life. Come on, people, surely you can see this. If Scripture proves that I am my Father's servant, then rejecting those scriptures is not going to get you in his favor. This man thinks that as long as he keeps the commandments that he will be good. This is not true, so he is spreading yet another lie by saying that this is the bottom line. He wrote me that doing so is the bottom line, keeping the commandments, and I wrote him back and said that love is the bottom line. Also, I said in so many of these videos that the bottom line is that we keep the commandments so that we can be made in his image through them. Yes, it is a must that we keep the commandments, but keeping them must be a matter of letting them make us in his image through keeping them. I said that this man said that when I say this about being made in his image, that I'm completely contradicting the scriptures. Is this true? Or, as I said earlier, am I understanding why we are here and why we were created? I think that I have made the point that he is not speaking the truth with his claim that I am contradicting the scriptures in this statement. He certainly did not offer an alternative explanation for why we must keep the commandments in all of his infinite wisdom. He is definitely wise in his own understanding. As I said, like Saul, he has come in his own authority with his lies and has spoken against my Father's word, and he has rejected his word. And yes, it is love to expose this. It is love to others that might buy into his theories. If he is not coming out and saying that I'm false directly, even if he's not coming out and saying that I'm false directly, he has put forth error once again in painting the picture that I am false. Like I said, that's how this all started, was me telling him to stop posting the error. And for just to be a student until he knows the answers. As I said, this is how Satan works. He puts forth error and paints a false picture. Like I said, with Eve, what he did in the garden. Same thing over and over again. It is even love to him that I'm exposing this in this video, because I hope that this admonishment will cause him to turn from Satan's snares that he's been caught in. The other place that he said that I contradicted the scriptures is that I said that the locusts that come out of the deep well are destroying angels and not demons. Maybe he needs to read a few verses further. It says in Revelation 9:11, speaking of the 150 days, 5 months, it says, and they had a king over them, which is the angel of the deep well, whose name in the Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, which means the destroyer. And in the Greek tongue, his name is Apollyon, which also means the destroyer. It says an angel here. The king of over the these locusts is an angel. Is Satan an angel still? Are he and his cronies already bound in the prison that they'll be bound in for 1,000 years, that they would need to be let loose for this 5-month period? Was he ever referred to as the destroying angel in the rest of scriptures? No, our Creator has destroying servants that he used in the past, like on the night of the Passover and when he struck down 70,000 from the tribes of Israel. Satan is not the king, and he is already loosed. He cannot be let loose if he and his boys are already loose. I explained this to this man in detail, yet he obviously has rejected it, as he has rejected my father's word to verify it. It was given to verify his prophet. He also questioned whether I have indeed turned the water into blood as well. And we'll just address this proof in the Proofs and Prophecies video that I'll be doing here in the next day or two. And I have explained this proof to this man, and it is irrefutable. And even he cannot refute it. Even he said this in his video, yet he still murmurs against it. Wow, and he is always saying how he fears his Creator. I don't see the fear, nor do I see the love in it, that he is not afraid that he might point another away from the true path. Like I said, I've given him all the verses that prove that prophesied about me, and he's still preaching against it. How is that fear? Don't you think that he might just lead one astray? Looked at a couple of his comments from the video, and that's, believe me, people will buy into his nonsense because they don't want to hear anyway. But I'm sharing this event with you and to show others of how easy it is to get deterred if we will not trust and believe our Creator. We have to be so careful to guard his word with all of our being. And it is a commandment to do so, to guard his word. If we don't, he gives us over to the enemy to be sifted. As I said, this man is certainly not challenging me anyway. He is facing off with his Creator's word, and therefore he is standing toe-to-toe with his Maker in stubborn rebellion to him. As I said, he is thinking that as long as he is keeping the commandments, that he is in good with him. Well, how did that work out for Job? Of course, Job was brought to repentance, and I hope that this man will be as well. How did it work for Korah and the 250 princes of Israel that went up against Moses and Aaron? And again, this man says he's not going up against me. Well, listen to this video. He says that out of the corner of one mouth, and the next corner of the mouth, he's telling me how I'm contradicting scriptures with all his wisdom. How was it working out for the Pharisees and the Sadducees in the time that Yeshua came the first time? It did not sound like just keeping the Torah was going to cut it for them. This man recently covered his head because the commandment went forward through me to cover it. And this is good. This is one of the verses that he denies, though. Not the covering the head thing. Obviously, he covered his head. The verse says that when this commandment goes forth, that you can know that it came from him. How you slice it up, that's what it says. Would it be possible for another to bring forth this commandment in error? If you say yes, then you are calling Elohim a liar, because he said that when it goes forth, you can know that it is him. So obviously this man, by denying that verse, is calling Yahweh Elohim a liar. He will find out that his physical covering is just going to heap a much higher measure of my father's wrath on him for denying his work. Unless, of course, he repents. As I said, I am not self-proclaiming, but this man is, and woe to him for using the same terminology on me when the opposite is true. It is my father's word that proclaims that I am his servant. Therefore, this man is proclaiming that my father's word is not good enough for him. For some reason, I do not think that this is going to work out for him or for any of you that refuse to believe him. He will soon find out that he was not yet made in his image after all, and that he has rejected that which would have made him in his image. It's more than just the commandments. He might not be rejecting the commandments, but he has made the marriage contract null and void by committing fornication with the bridegroom. I'm not sure if he was in this contract in the first place or not, because his repentance seemed to still be wavering. It appears that he was still seeking understanding from other sources, and this is not what a chaste bride does. But if he was in this contract, then he certainly has broken his vows and is now back in the enemy's influence. The main thing to understand is, if we are not in the covenant, then we do not have his seven spirits guiding us, the removed. And they are what we need to learn the spiritual intent of the commandments. Keeping the commandments on just a physical plane is not all of what this testing phase that we call life is about. We need more than the commandments. They do not mold us in his image by themselves. And I've spoke on this over and over again. We must have him and his son living in and through us through his seven spirits, and they are not going to live in a rebellious house that refuses to believe them. So keeping the commandments will not see this man through what is ahead, nor will any of the rest of you come through what is ahead by keeping the commandments by themselves, which you certainly will need to be found doing them as well. We must be a chaste bride that believes his word and acts on this belief by living it in purity. Denying his word and denying what his word was sent to accomplish is not going to bring you under his wings. As I said earlier, 143,999 others have come to this realization, and so will each of you have to.